I'm a mediator.
Amen.
He takes a position between God and man. And he says, I've paid the price. But what happens when we've done stuff and we have not repented? What happens if the enemy comes with the accusation, you know, and we are guilty? We have not repented. The Bible says if we repent, his blood cleanses us and purifies us.
Yes.
If we confess our sins, he's faithful and righteous to forgive us of all iniquities.
Yes.
And unrighteousness. So just look at this picture. There's the accuser checking you out. And he puts stumbling blocks in your way.
Come on. And then
he causes you to stumble and to fall.
Come on.
But now you are falling in the trap and zoom, he's back. God, look at Mary. Look what she did. Look at John, look what he did. He accuses us. But you know what? If you come and you say, Lord, forgive me. The blood of Jesus cleanses us, purifies us, forgives us our lives. I see the advocate stands up and says, Father, wait.
Thank you, Lord.
He says, Satan, I rebuke you. I pay the price on the cross of Calvary. My blood covers John. My blood covers Peter. My blood covers Mary. And the Father declares he's innocent. I declare him righteous.
Thank you.
Brethren, I'm speaking of the accuser. And there's another point I want to bring. When we take up the position of being an accuser, we are called a Satan. If we take up the position of accusing, we are standing with the devil. We are positioning ourselves on Satan's side because he is the accuser. Now we take the same position of accusing. There's three areas where we use accusations. Number one, we accuse ourselves.
Amen.
We accuse ourselves. I think most of us are unhappy on the way, how we look, what we do, or how we react to stuff. We accuse ourselves. When you look in the mirror, then you don't like your ears, you don't like your nose, you don't like your eyes. I don't like my eyes. You're accusing yourself. You look in the mirror, whatever. I don't like my legs. My legs are too fat or my legs are too thin. And we have all these things. I want to change. I want to change your words from today. I want you to change the way you see yourself. When you look at the person in the mirror, say, wow, that is a handsome person. That's a beautiful person. I like what I see. I like the eyes I see. I like everything I see. Oh, hallelujah. Because God has made you wonderfully and he's made you perfectly. And he's made you fearfully. So stop criticizing yourself. Stop accusing yourself. Can you imagine you say this and this and this about you? The devil is off to God and saying, she says that about herself.
That's
right. She's saying that about herself. But today we cancel in the name of Jesus. We cancel every accusation. Every word I spoke against myself, I repeat it, I cancel it. I stop it this morning in the name of Jesus. I will not put myself down anymore.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody told you one time that you were not so intelligent. Now you repeat it to yourself all the time. I'm not so intelligent, I can't do this, I can't do that. We change every word of negativity over our lives this morning in the name of Jesus. We will not accuse ourselves anymore in the name of Jesus. And the devil has got no accusation against us anymore. Number two, the accusations we level against our family members, against our loved ones. Let us stop it today. You know, the husband comes from mama's house, and you know how nice mama fried the steaks and did that fried chicken and stuff. Now the wife doesn't know how to boil water. And he says to the wife, You can't cook. You are hopeless. And you know, and then the longer you're together, it happens many times that we lose respect for one another. I've been married for more than 37 years, okay? We lose respect, we begin to say stuff that we shouldn't say.
Right.
And those negative words we speak, and when the wife speaks of the husband, that husband of mine. And then the things follow. But this morning, there's no more accusations. This morning we stop with every accusation. You know what? If the meat is burnt, put a smile on your face and chew it anyway. Oh, hallelujah. Sometimes there's too much salt. Drink a bit of water with it. Sometimes there's no salt, just add a bit of salt. Well, I'm preaching to myself also this morning. But no more accusations, no more accusations in the name of Jesus. Can you see what happens? You are praying for the salvation of your husband, but just before you start praying, you see this stupid husband, this lazy husband, and then this accusation is standing before God.
Amen.
And now you pray, Lord have mercy, but the devil says, listen what she said before. Today we stop it in the name of Jesus. We stop it in the name of Jesus. The things we accuse our kids about, this boy of me, he will never make it in life. This girl, she's just like auntie. Whatever, when we speak these things, and we want God to bless our children. Look what Job did. They come back, he sanctifies them.
Yeah.
And he offers for them. He wants God's divine protection over them. And the hedge that might have been broken is now repaired.
Yeah.
And how many times do we break the hedge around our own families? Because of our careless words.
Come on.
When you speak of your loved ones, and even the brethren in the church, don't bring accusations anymore.
Amen.
We're not standing on the side of Satan. We're standing on the side of God. What does God do? What does Jesus do? He intercedes. He intercedes. But whenever he sees a problem, he intercedes. And I want us as a church to move from accusations to intercessors. No one accuser, now an intercessor. I believe, brethren, that being an accuser and being an intercessor is the different sides of the same coin. You can either intercede or you can accuse. But this morning we become intercessors in the name of Jesus. This morning we change the way we see things, the way we do things, the way we speak. We will not speak negative of anybody anymore, of any situation anymore. We will intercede, we will pray. I want us this morning to take up the position of an intercessor. Church, your child is difficult. Things are tough. But instead of focusing on the negative, let us begin to repent on their behalf.
Yes. Amen.
Lord, on behalf of my daughter, I repent. On behalf of my son, I repent.
Amen.
And after you've repented, then you begin to intercede. Lord, save, deliver, set free. Break the yokes, break the powers of darkness. Release your blessings, release your favor.
Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
And you will see how God will come through. Move away from accusing. God knows what's the problem. The devil loves the problem. But we're going to change what we do. We're not going to accuse anymore. We're going to intercede. We sanctify them first. Lord, wash them, cleanse them, purify them. Lord, I repent on their behalf. Lord, I repent for the closed eyes. I repent for what they are doing. Now, Lord, cover them. Bring them back home. Change their hearts. Change their lives. Number one, we repent. Number two, we intercede. Number three, prophesy. Prophesy over your house. Prophesy over your husband, your wife. Prophesy over your kids. Prophesy over your loved ones. Do you know you can speak the word of God over your children?
Yes.
Over your family? Over your situation? Over your business. You can prophesy, you can speak. We are children of God. We are filled with the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of the living God is inside of us.
Amen.
And when you speak a word, that word has got power. You speak a word of success. You speak a word of blessings. You speak a word of healing, of prosperity. It will come to pass. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. You know, your child is struggling with maths. Why don't you prophesy that he will master maths? Your child is struggling with physics, with science. Why don't you prophesy he will master science? He will understand physics. Your boy hasn't worked for a long time. Begin to pray for him, prophesy. He will find a job and he will get promoted in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. Let there be a change of how we do things, now we see things. Close the hedge. Let us close the hedge. Job did anything, everything to close the hedge. We don't follow the way of the accuser. We become intercessors. And we close every hedge. We close the hedge when we repent. And we close the hedge when we intercede. We stop the plan of the enemy. Let us stand on our feet. I think I've spoken enough. Hallelujah. Lift your hands to heaven. Praise God. As our hands are lifted to heaven, begin to speak to the Lord. Ask God for grace, mercy, and favor. Let us start by repenting. Every one of us, somehow, has taken the position of an accuser. It is not over our own lives, over our families, our loved ones, and even over the brethren, accusing. But now with boldness, repent. Say, Lord, I repent, forgive me. I've been using words that was not right. And saying things that's not right. Every word of accusation against my own life, I rebuke it now. And I cancel it, I stop it. But every word I've spoken over my own life, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I stop it, I repent of it. And Lord, this morning, I repent of every word of accusation I brought against my husband, against my wife. I repent, Lord, of every word of accusation that I brought against my children, my family members, my loved ones. I repent of it. And I cancel those things that I said in the name of Jesus. Lord, every word of accusation, every negative thing I've said about anybody, about your brethren, your sons and daughters, I repent of it. And I cancel what I've said. I pray for your grace now to cover me. Lord, right now, I want to enter into the position of an intercessor. Begin to pray this, say this, Lord, I want to enter into the position of an intercessor right now. I want my words to be changed. Lord, I stand on behalf of my family members, of myself. And I pray that you will sanctify and wash, cleanse us, purify us. Forgive us when we have sinned. Where my family has sinned, where my husband, wife has sinned, where my children have sinned. Please forgive us. You're a God of grace, you're a God of mercy. Brethren, I do believe we can repent on behalf of our children. Because we step in and we act as mediators. And I bring my family before you with all the weaknesses, all the shortcomings. And I say, Lord, forgive, cleanse, wash, purify. Remove the scales from our eyes. Open our minds so we can see your love, your understanding. Let us experience your goodness and your mercies. Oh Lord, we intercede now for our family members. We We call them to salvation.
Yes.
We call them to deliverance. We call them to freedom. We call the blessings upon their lives. Lord, wherever they find themselves, let your angels be with them. Let the Spirit of the living God protect them and cover them. Lord, those that are sick, let your healing power be released upon every person. Those that are in bondage, my children that are in bondage, deliver them from the power of the bondage. Deliver them from the power of the devil. Set them free from every wickedness. Loosen them, release them. Come on, stay, take that position of an intercessor. Begin to pray for those that are struggling. Begin to pray for those that are having a hard time. For those that are sick, those that are bound, those that are oppressed. You can see the problem and you can intercede for them. Begin to intercede in the name of Jesus. Lama shakota da shekita rasokota lama sata. Daba anda maka sheke. Lord, we pray for those that are in bondage. Our children. Oh Lord, the spirit of fear over our children. The spirit of fear. The spirit of intimidation. Oh Lord, every wickedness, every plan of the devil. Lord, that nervous condition. Whatever the kids are going through, what our families are going through, we bring them before you now. You're the God of grace. You're the God of mercy. You are long suffering. Now, Lord, let your favor come upon our people. Let your blessings rain upon our children.
And then this couple suddenly, they began to experience thoughts of a
from you all. That's the cause of your problem. They took it off, they burned it, they were free. Sometimes we have stuff in our houses where the devil has got to lead to. Sometimes there's things that we've done, we open the door and the enemy has got to lead to it. Get rid of it! Get rid of it! Go through the rooms of your kids and if there's stuff you don't like, it's your house, get rid of it! Go into every room of your house, get oil, anoint the rooms, anoint the doors, bring God's blessings over your house, over every room, that the blessing of God must be in your house. The presence of God must be in your house. Hallelujah. Usually there's a reason why the Lord allowed me to speak this, but I'm giving you advice. Don't get so stuck to something because it's expensive. Get rid of it. A few years ago, we were looking through these, my wife and I, what do you call this? These magazines where they advertise stuff and you buy it. Catalog. And then there was this beautiful, I think Japanese or Chinese robes, pure silk. Yeah, and I bought one from him for my wife. When he came, there was this big dragon at the back of it. And we said, wow, we don't like this. We burnt it. It cost us a lot of money, but we burnt it. You might say, you are paranoid. I don't know, but this is what I know. I want God's blessings. Yes. And I will do everything to maintain God's blessings. Yes. Yes. And I said to the church this morning, make sure the hedge around you and your family is shut. The enemy has got no way to come in. And you will experience God's blessings. The devil said, you've blessed the work of his hands and you have increased in every way. That is what I release upon you this morning. Come at us. I want you to do the next thing. Let us begin to prophesy. You can prophesy, okay? They say this about the Jewish families, specifically the Orthodox. I think you know that they start the Sabbath starts Friday night. And they will have a meal and stuff. Then the father will lay hands on every child of him and bless their child. He will bless him to be a doctor, bless him to be a lawyer, bless him to be, successful, prosperous. And he can look over the Jewish families. Generally, they are prosperous. And I want you now to begin to prophesy over your family. Lift your hands to heaven. Be bold, don't be afraid, be bold. We have our high priest. We have our intercessor. We have Jesus Christ as the mediator between God and man. So call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Begin to prophesy. I prophesy blessings over all my children. I prophesy success and prosperity. My children will serve the Lord. They will serve the Lord in spirit and in truth. I prophesy my kids will be involved in the ministry in the name of Jesus. I prophesy financial blessings upon their lives. I prophesy success. I prophesy that they will have promotion. They will be increased. They will be promoted. They will be blessed. Whatever the head starts will be blessed. Right now. Most probably your son or your daughter doesn't have a good marriage, but you prophesy a good marriage. You prophesy healing to that marriage. You prophesy healing to your grandchildren. Blessings upon your grandchildren. The blessings of God is coming upon your family. Hallelujah. 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 Are you prophesying? Anybody can prophesy because you've got the Spirit of the Lord inside of you. I prophesy in the name of Jesus. The blessings of God upon my children, upon my wife. The blessings of God upon everyone in this church. I prophesy that the Lord will remain with you. The Holy Spirit will continue to speak to you. And areas in your life that needs to be fixed, will fix it in the name of Jesus. I prophesy now that wherever the hedge has been opened and broken, the hedge will be closed in the name of Jesus. I prophesy over you this morning that you will have success. You will have prosperity. I prophesy today that what the devil tried to do against you will be nullified in the name of Jesus. Every plague There's one more thing that Job did all the time. He sacrificed for his family. He sacrificed. I want to encourage you, brethren. There are times when you've prayed and fasted and you don't see the miracle yet. Give an offering for that problem. Give an offering for that problem. If you've been struggling to get promoted, most probably you must sow